Hi there, Brian Dunbar from Grex Airbrush. In a recent video, we demonstrated how to disassemble and assemble the Tritium pistol grip style airbrush. For those of you that prefer a traditional style double action airbrush, we'd like to do the same with our new Genesis series airbrushes. With our new Genesis series airbrushes, we have two styles. We have the Gravity Feed XGI and we have the Side Feed XSI. Both airbrushes have the same internal parts, so for the sake of demonstration, we will go ahead and utilize the XGI for our disassembly and assembly process. To do this, we only need one tool, which is the wrench that comes in the box with the airbrush. With the new Genesis line of airbrushes, they are similar to the Tritiums in that they have a magnetized crown and nozzle. So we're going to go ahead and simply remove those right now and put those off to the side. Now we also have this rubberized grip, and this just very easily slides right off of the airbrush. We'll also go ahead and take the rubberized trigger pad off as well. Now, let's go ahead and address the color cup. We have a cap, and then the color cup itself just unthreads. On the back side of the airbrush, we have the handle. Simply unthread that. We have the needle lock, which we will first loosen to remove the needle. Then we'll go ahead and unthread it the rest of the way. Now we have the spring housing, and along with it will come the needle chuck and needle spring, and they simply separate as such. Returning back to the airbrush body, now we have the trigger. It simply lifts right out of the body, and we also have the actuator, and it also slides out conveniently. On the front end of the airbrush, we have our nozzle cap. And once it's removed, it now exposes the fluid nozzle. And this is where the wrench comes in. The wrench has a hexagonal shape to it that agrees with the fluid nozzle. We simply interface the two, and we want to turn counterclockwise to loosen it, remove the wrench, and now we can simply remove the fluid nozzle utilizing our fingers. And there we go. So now we have the air valve assembly. Let's go ahead and unthread that. And lastly, we have the piston, which is again in the stem portion of the airbrush body, and we're simply going to turn it over, and there we go. There's the piston. So now we have fully disassembled the XGI airbrush. Okay, so we have gone ahead and fully disassembled the Genesis XGI airbrush. So now let's go ahead and reassemble it. First, we're going to address the air valve. Simply thread it into the base of the airbrush body by hand. Hand tight is fine. And now we have the piston, which in profile has this T shape to it. And you want to keep it orientated that way when you drop it into the airbrush. If it goes in upside down, you need to do it over again. And there, it dropped in perfectly. Next, we want to address the actuator. There's a flat inside of the airbrush that holds it into place. We also want to address that it has this curved shape here, which interfaces with the trigger. Now with the trigger, to ensure that it goes in correctly, there's a high side here, and we want that towards the back, and the airbrush simply drops in, and there we go. Okay, now we want to adjust the chuck, the spring, and the spring housing. Now there's a hexagonal shape here on the chuck that interfaces with the housing, and we want to interface the two together. Now because of the spring inside, it's now under load, so you want to be careful, but go ahead and now thread the assembly into the airbrush. You want to thread it all the way in until it stops and just make sure it's good and secure. Now let's go ahead and address the front end of the airbrush and the fluid nozzle. So let's go ahead and simply thread it on again by finger. Once it's in most of the way, we can go ahead and now we want to utilize the wrench one more time, counterclockwise until it snugs up. You don't need to put a lot of weight on that or you will strip out the threads on the fluid nozzle. Now let's go ahead and protect the fluid nozzle with the nozzle cap. Again, just hand tight is fine. And let's return to the back end of the airbrush. Let's go ahead and thread the lock nut on. We want to keep that loose right now though, because we're going to slide the needle into the airbrush body. Gently push it forward until it comes to a stop. It has stopped at the fluid nozzle. Tighten the nut, and now everything is working properly. Next, we can go ahead and put the handle on. We'll go ahead and put the color cup on, along with the cover. Now we can put the grips back on the airbrush. They just starch right over the valve assembly, along with the trigger pad. And then lastly, we have the magnetized nozzle and consequently the crown, which either one could go fore or aft. So now we have reassembled the Genesis XGI airbrush.